Well, good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. Today, our government is announcing increases to public school funding by $20.8 million. This is a 1.56% increase for a total commitment of $1.3 $5 billion for the 21-22 year. This is a record high investment in our children's education. We are increasing the base funding for public schools by 0.5% or $6.7 million. In addition, our government is increasing funding for special needs by $5.5 million. School divisions continue to be protected by the formula guarantee, ensuring that every division will receive at least 98% of last year's funding. Both of these increases are alongside other grants. Our government is committed to ensuring that school divisions would not see a reduction in their funding if their enrollment changed due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Our government continues to support Manitobans during this challenging time, and we will be reducing the unfair local property tax burden for local ratepayers. This year, school divisions will freeze education property taxes, and in return, the province will be providing a property tax offset grant equivalent to a 2% education property tax increase, or 22.8 million dollars. This will be paid direct to school districts. We continue to work with school divisions in addressing the impacts of COVID-19, which includes both the ongoing focus on healthy learning environments, as well as planning for education recovery in the classroom. Over the coming months, our government will continue to engage with teachers and parents to ensure we are targeting our investments to support the needs of all students. Today's funding is the annual funding announcement, and this is in addition to keeping our schools safe through the $185 million Safe Schools funding announcement earlier this year for COVID-related expenses. Our government continues to make historic investments in the K-12 education system to support Manitoba children in achieving their full potential. Our province overall spends the third highest in the country on education. In spite of this, Manitoba students have continued to face challenges with their educational outcomes for a number of years as compared to their peers. We often rank near the bottom of interprovincial comparisons to those who fund education at lower rates. We need an education system that is outcomes focused and has the student achievement first. Students and parents deserve this. We will ensure that our students do not fall further behind, and it is important we set our students up for the opportunity to succeed. We are looking to the future to ensure we can be Canada's most improved education system. Today, our government is proving that regardless of the changes that our system needs or the challenges in front of us, we will be there to continue to support our students, our families, and our education partners. Our government believes that our students have a significant opportunity to grow and to learn. Thank you very much, and I'm have some time to field your questions.
Thank you, Minister. A reminder to our reporters on the line, you will have one preliminary and one follow-up question this morning. And up first this morning from the Winnipeg Sun, James.
Hey, good morning. I'm just wondering if education spending in 2021 is projected to be on par with last year?
Like last year we were at a 0.5%. We've carried forward the operating grant at the 0.5% level. We've added additional grants this year, as well as a $5.5 million additional commitment for special needs for Manitoba students. That brings us to a total of $20.8 million, which is, when you put those numbers together, it's a 1.56% increase to funding for education in the K-12 system in Manitoba.
Thank you.
From CTV Winnipeg, Stephanie.
Hi. I saw in the release it's just talking about how the province is committed to modernizing the education system. Are you able to elaborate on what that means?
Sure. I referenced, obviously, spending. We're spending about the third highest in the country in terms of education. Unfortunately, our results are behind some of our counterparts across the country. In fact, and a lot of times we're very near the bottom in terms of outcomes. Clearly, that's why we asked for the K-12 review. We now have that review in front of us. And we look forward to bringing that review to Manitobans in the very near future. And at the same time, we'll be responding to that review and providing Manitobans our government's direction in terms of how we will continue to work with Manitobans to improve the education outcomes for Manitoba students.
And are you able to say when we can expect this K-12 review?
I just ask you to stay tuned. Obviously, there's a lot of work being done behind the scenes in terms of the review and our setting our goals for the future. So I'll just ask you to stay tuned, and we'll let you know very shortly when that report will be available.
From City News, Jonas.
Good morning, Mr. Minister. Just wanted to touch base on some COVID-19 protocols and spending within the education system on the back of a report from the Canadian Centre for Policy Alternatives this week. This is what it says in the report. It says of the $140 a person devoted to COVID-19 measures in childcare and schools, Manitoba is only contributing 28%. The rest of the money is from federal transfers. And just wanted to get your take on what money is in the pot or in the province's pocket from the feds, and what's gone out, and how this relates to it.
Right. Well, I'll certainly speak to the K-12 portion. First of all, we've asked school districts over the course of last year, when they had some savings, to make sure they put that money aside, use it for COVID-related expenses. We do appreciate the close to $85 million we did receive from the federal government. The province is also picking up net of that as well. We have set aside a total of $185 million for COVID-related expenses. I will tell you that as of the end of December this past year, we have committed to almost $62 million of that particular fund. So we're certainly committed to safety of our students here in Manitoba.
Thank you for that, sir. I guess just on the COVID-19 front and in schools, some of the initiatives that have gone out, and is there anything additional planned here coming up?
In terms of COVID, obviously, you know, we've been working closely with school districts, superintendents, teachers, parents on this front, and we will continue that dialogue as we move forward. Clearly, we take direction from the officials at public health. These are the experts when it comes to public health safety of both certainly our adult population and our students in K-12. So we're working closely with them. We're meeting regularly with them. I will say certainly from a safety perspective, it certainly appears that school settings are safe. Our public health people have informed us of that. We don't foresee any substantial changes in the near future. And again, we'll continue to work with our key stakeholders to make sure Manitoba students stay safe in schools.
From the Winnipeg Free Press, Maggie.
Hi, Minister Cullen. I was wondering if you can explain more about the property tax, the education property tax being phased out, what exactly that's going to look like, and also with the 2.8 figure that you had given, if that the $22.8 million, if that is going to be dispersed evenly across school divisions so everyone gets 2.8% of the equivalent of a 2.8% increase.
No, thanks for that question. That allows me a chance to clarify. You know, clearly our government has made the commitment that we want to reduce the property tax education component off of property taxes for Manitobans. We've made that commitment. I would say this is the first step in addressing that. We've asked the school boards to freeze over the last couple of years at the 2% level. This year we're asking them to freeze it at 0%. So in lieu of that, the province of Manitoba will be picking up the tab. They will be paying the 2% component direct to the school boards. As you say, that represents almost $23 million. So that will save local property taxpayers $23 million this year. Not every school district in Manitoba increased their property taxes last year by 2%. Many did. But we are taking the first step to lessen the burden for the individual homeowners.
Okay. Can school divisions go into a deficit with all the funding? Divisions have already spent the savings that they had in the spring. Some are projecting some deficits and calling for additional funding from the province. So can you explain that?
Sure. I think they will be happy with our funding announcement for the future. And clearly, we still have money sitting in our COVID account to deal with COVID-related expenses. We will be using certainly some of that money for the remainder of the school year. We're also looking at potentially carrying some money of that fund over into next year. As school board said, there could be ongoing costs related to COVID. Clearly, we're working closely with school districts in terms of their operations, any potential funding shortfalls. We clearly recognize there's challenges, COVID-related and other challenges there, and we are committed to working closely with school boards to address their financial concerns and their financial issues, and we will continue that dialogue.
From Global News, Joe.
Hi there. I am wondering if you have any thoughts on what spring break should look like this year. Ontario put up the possibility of maybe changing or canceling spring breaks. I'm just wondering what plans are here.
Yeah, thanks for that question, and provides me an opportunity to clarify that. We are going to carry forward with spring break. We think the teachers, students, and probably parents require a break. So the plans will continue forward with spring break as we know it. But having said that, again, as Dr. Rusin has said, we ask people to stay home, be mindful of travel restrictions, and be mindful of public health orders that are in place.
Thank you. And I'm just wondering in general what your thoughts are on how the school year is going so far, you know, given the situation. Any surprises?
Yeah, obviously we recognize it's been a difficult situation for so many individuals, students and parents and administrators across the board. I think we're, in general terms, we're quite happy. You know, the relative cases in schools is relatively low. Certainly our public health officials are working closely with individual schools. They're monitoring individual situations. And I would say, you know, given the COVID conditions across the province, across the country, I think things are going quite well. Clearly, we have to be mindful, though. We recognize there's variants out there of this virus, so we certainly have to be mindful, and we certainly have to continue to make sure that we are doing everything we can to protect our students and our educators. So we're certainly not out of the woods. I think we all have to be diligent as we move forward, and be mindful. There's a long way to go before this current pandemic is over. So I would say positive so far, fingers crossed. We all have to work together to be diligent and protect each other.
from the Brandon Sun, Kyle.
Good morning, Minister. A couple of weeks ago, you announced that the province was setting aside more than $24 million for 7 future land acquisition projects, including 2 new school sites in Brandon, one of which is a DSFM facility. I was wondering if you could, at this point, divulge any more details on these projects, like a possible timeline or talks with the respective school divisions.
I don't have anything further to add at this point in time. We'll certainly keep you appraised. Obviously, our central services department is working closely with the school boards in terms of acquiring property for those developments. We obviously see the need for future developments in the community of Brandon, and certainly looking forward to putting this investment in terms of our capital plan going forward. Obviously, 20 new schools is quite an undertaking, but we're happy to make that investment on behalf of Manitobans.
All right, thank you.
With no further reporters, no further questions, this concludes our media briefing. Thank you.
Thanks, everyone.